The diversity of students at STIC is very large, and in my opinion, if you believe in education and you really want to get to learn new things, you have to have diverse people. It's a must to have diversity, and so STIC has a great diversity of learners. They are an access for people who are later in life, so that they can learn careers after high school. They've got a lot of single mothers, single parents, a lot of activity for people to learn and build a new career if they want. My program director called me a crooked arrow, somebody that didn't go high school, college, medical school. Right. Had a little bit of experience after college, before I went to medical school. And it's interesting, people say, was that a waste of time or not a waste of time? And it's like, I teach now, so my experience as a teacher and a coach have come in to play a big role in what I do today. So as I've told people, everything that you've done in the past is going to help you be better at what you're doing today. If you went back in your 20s, 30s, even 40s, the experiences you've had in the past are going to make you better at what you're going to do in healthcare. So it's always good. It's never too late to change your career plans. We need all sorts of people. We need people that can write, because we need to write things in the language that our patients are in. We need them to write at the level of our patients. So if you're interested in English or writing, there's an opportunity. In finance, you could go to Wall Street, but you could go to Bay State or a healthcare institution, because we need people that understand the finance, because we need to stay here. We need to be financially viable. So any aspect of a career that you want could be done in healthcare. Then there are the clinical, the doctors, the nurses, the techs, the MAs, the community health workers. It's just a whole litany of people that are needed on the healthcare team with different skill sets. So there is a place that we could find for you to work in healthcare. One of the strengths of STIC is it has a diversity of persons that are graduating from there, and they have the skill that you need. I don't want to be too boastful, but we helped develop a lot of the STIC students, so we know some of the skills that they have. And as I said, the diversity of persons is really a strength, and it's not a nice to have, it's a must to have if you want to continue to learn and innovate. So there's a strength that you know that they're well trained, and there's a diversity of person coming from STIC. People will have a different view, they'll have a different approach just because of their background. And that's where innovation comes in, because somebody will say, well, why don't you do it this way? Why don't you do I never thought of that, just because of my limited background. And so having that diversity of idea, diversity of opinion, helps everyone get better and improve. The biggest advantage of diversity is that there's a more cultural awareness, reaching out to the different patient populations, having somebody that looks and sounds like me taking care of me is reassuring. I can work to take care of different people from different cultures, but there's somebody that speaks a native language, there's somebody that looks a little bit more, that's a little bit more reassuring. So I need to work on my skills, because I work with people of different cultures and different backgrounds, but I think we need to get more people of diversity and different cultures and different backgrounds in the healthcare field for the purposes that you just said. There's not a lot of people that are in the field, so it's hard for me to say, oh, I could do that, because there's so many people that look like me. So we really need to make a more concerted effort, and I think STIC is working towards that. Okay.